Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we're going to color match these three shots in HitFilm. I'm going to be working in HitFilm Express 15, and the color matching tool that I'm going to use is actually an add-on tool. If you search under the color grading folder, you will find an effect that is called grading transfer, and that will be the effect that I'm using. It is an add-on, so if you click on this, then you will find that it is part of the color LUT add-on pack, which is $19.99 or $20. However, if you were to go to the HitFilm Express, download HitFilm Express to the Pay What You Want page, then you will find that it also is included right here in the Content Creator pack, which is only $19, and that Pay What You Want pack includes a whole bunch of other effects, both in the Starter and the Content Creator pack as well, plus 15% of what you spend goes to a good cause. So consider getting that. This also comes standard in Pro. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in three different shots. I'm going to start with this shot of a surfer gazing out at the ocean, looking at what he's going to conquer. And then I'm going to go to this shot, which is a bunch of waves crashing against some rocks. And then finally, the last shot, which is, oh, he's actually surfing those waves, right? So now using my ripple edit tool, I will just sort of bring these together a little bit here very quickly. I don't want these to be long, long, long. And now what I have here is him looking out, and then the waves are crashing, and then we have the surfing shot. The problem is it's pretty obvious that these are not from the same sources. This shot obviously is a golden hour early in the morning or maybe late in the afternoon. It is bathed in warm tones, orange and yellows. This shot is probably mid-morning shot based on the shadows here, or perhaps mid-afternoon. This is obviously all in greens. And then this one here is probably, it's cloudy. There are no stark shadows. It's probably in the middle of the day, maybe noon. Okay. And it is clearly blue. So what I want to do is I want to take this orange and yellow shot, this green shot, and this blue shot, and I want to match them so that they all look the same and they all look like they belong together. Okay, so the grading transfer or color match effect is the effect that we're going to use. It is a layer only effect. What that means, if you ever see layer only, means that you cannot drag this onto something in the editor timeline. It can only be applied to a layer that is in a composite shot. So what I will have to do is make this into a composite shot to be able to use this effect. So what I will do is right click on the beach shot, and I will say make into a composite shot. Control M is the hotkey for that. Then I will go ahead and apply the grading transfer effect to the beach shot. Opening this up, you realize, oh, I have to grade this from another shot. And what I want to do is I want to use this surfing shot, this blue shot, as my reference. So I'm going to go ahead and drag this in, and then grading from, I will select surfing. And now you can see that it has made this look blue like the other shot looks. So it essentially is making this shot look the same as that shot. Okay. So now that one is done, I just want to do this one. I will right click and make into a composite shot, clicking OK. I will drag the grading transfer effect onto the waves. And again, I will bring in the surfing video so that I can reference it. And poof, now it has that same blue color to it. Look at that. And that's it. I mean, it's really just that simple. Now we have three shots in a row that are the same color grade. Okay. If you look at this effect a little bit more closely, you can see that there are some tweaking that can happen here. The brightness shift can be adjusted. That is how bright it is or how dark the shot is. Also, what is referred to as the chrominance shift tells you how much of that blue basically is going to be put in here or how much is not. In other words, how much up to 200% are you going to add into there? You can do this in the shadows, you can do this in the midtones, and you can do this in the highlights. So this is a great effect for somebody who, like me, who isn't very good at color grading, but still wants to get these shots to match each other. So it's really a pretty simple effect, and I'm really fond of it. There's another way to use this effect also that involves using reference material instead of another shot to grading transfer your picture or your video. So in this case, I have an example of a picture of an office, and I have this picture that is entitled Blade Runner, and I have this picture that is entitled The Matrix, and I put these in here. I'm going to drag this grading transfer layer or effect, in here, and then say grade from The Matrix movie barcode, and look, it looks very much like The Matrix, if you think about how The Matrix would look. And if I were to source Blade Runner, think about how Blade Runner looks, the movie style. This is the Blade Runner movie style look. So you say, where would I find something like these reference photos? Well, I will leave a link in the description for this website, the color grading inspiration, the beat here. These are movie barcodes and color palettes. And if you take a look, you can see this shot, basically, these are the color palettes, right, for that. Here is Tim Burton's Beetlejuice, and here's the color palette for that. Here is The Dark Knight, and here's the color palette for that. Here is Dazed and Confused, right, and so on and so forth. This is obviously Ghostbusters. And if you go down low enough, you can find movie barcodes. And so this is Blade Runner, this is Wizard of Oz, this is Harry Potter, this is Hero, vibrant color scheme, right? You can download these and use these, and they are all over in here. So feel free to take a look at this website and see if you can convert your films into the look and feel of other films. If you have any questions about this effect, feel free to leave them in the comments below. If you like this kind of content, do me a favor and like this video and subscribe to my channel. Click the little bell icon for notification. And as always, thanks for watching.